What's up everybody, welcome to another video. My name is Tom and today I want to talk about this little guy, the DJI Spark, and whether it is still worth buying 6 months after its release. So let's find that out. So those of you who've been around here a little bit longer probably already know that I've owned the Spark almost since the beginning. I guess I didn't pre-order it, but I ordered it straight away after it was officially released. So I recently realized. What's going on here today? So I recently realized that I have this thing for around 6 months now, and I just wanted to let you guys know what I think about it now and whether I would still recommend buying it as I did when I first got it. So let's begin with some positive aspects of the Spark that I really like about it. The first one, the most obvious one, is the size. This thing is so small. It's like, if you fly it around people, nobody even cares about you. They are aware that this is a drone, but they see it as more of a toy and not some kind of filmmaking tool. So if you want to fly around people and in cities and stuff like that, this thing is really good for you. I use it on a bunch of projects now, and I never had an issue where someone came up to me and said they didn't want to be filmed or what I'm doing here, or people got angry. And I heard this a lot from people using the Mavic or the Phantom, but I didn't experience such a thing, and I am pretty sure that this is because the Spark is so small. And since it is so small, you can carry it with you almost every time you're out there. You can just throw it in your backpack and you're good to go. And I know people say you can do the same thing as the Mavic, but the Mavic weighs around, I guess, 800 grams or something around that, and the Spark doesn't even weigh 300 grams. So it's less than half the weight of the Mavic. And this is pretty significant if you want to carry this around the whole day, like if you're on a vacation or something like that. So really think about that before buying either the Spark or the Mavic or an even bigger drone. The next huge advantage of the Spark is obviously the price. And even now DJI dropped the price during the Christmas time a little bit more, so it's really affordable now. I guess it's around 500 euro, the drone alone. So it's really, really affordable compared to the other DJI drones. Like the Mavic is still around 1,100 euro and the Phantom series is even more expensive. So if you just want to use this thing for like YouTube vlogs or some short travel videos, or you just don't have that big of a budget and have to keep the price in mind, a huge plus of the Spark is that it is really affordable. And I don't mean that this is cheap, because 500 euro is still a lot of money, but compared to other DJI drones and compared to what you get from the Spark, especially looking at the build quality, this is a really good price. The next thing I really like about the Spark is the image quality. Especially when it comes to photography, even if the Spark doesn't shoot in RAW, the image quality is pretty good. The images are really sharp, there's a lot of detail, and you even can shoot 4K pictures with the Spark, which is pretty amazing. Also, the video quality is pretty good, especially if you look at the size of the camera on the drone itself. It's really good. It doesn't shoot 4K, as we already know, and it doesn't seem like DJI wants to introduce 4K videos on a further update for the Spark. But the 1080 coming from the Spark is really good when it comes to sharpness and detail. So for non-professional projects and personal stuff, it's really usable. But now let's get into some negative things. And here I want to continue talking about the image quality, because what I found really annoying is the limited dynamic range of the Spark. Like if you're shooting in bright lighting conditions, the camera really struggles with deciding on what to expose. And often the final result is just some contrasty mess. And I often found the videos coming from the Spark really unusable when I filmed in hot lighting conditions. If you're shooting photos in such a lighting condition, this is not that much of a problem, because in Lightroom you can pretty easily lift the shadows all the way up. And since the photo files from the Spark contain a lot of detail, this isn't such a problem. But as for the 1080 video files, you will have a lot of problems if you want to lift the shadows all the way up. I tried this a lot of times, it almost always failed. So if you want to get some cinematic shots out of the spark and you want to film during the day, you should really wait until like the sun is blocked by some clouds or something like that, so that the light isn't that hard. If you're filming in really soft light, the image quality, as I said, is pretty good, it's pretty sharp, it's not oversaturated, it's pretty neutral in my opinion, and with perfect lighting conditions you can get really good video out of the spark. But if you want to use it for professional projects, keep in mind that you are really limited with video work on the spark. Another thing I really hate about the spark is the flight time, because DJI says that the spark has a flight time around 15 minutes, and that is kind of true, I found, but you always have to keep in mind that these 15 minutes begin to go down from that exact moment when you turn the spark on. So then you have to wait until the spark and the remote controller connects to each other. You have to wait until you get proper GPS signal, until you're up in the sky. And in that moment, you're like already down to 80% or something around that. And then the spark will automatically try to land around 20 to 15%. So in reality, you just have around 60% and 8 to 10 minutes to fly. So if you still think about buying the spark, you should get at least 3 batteries, at least. And you should keep in mind that the spark isn't the most reliable drone to fly, at least when it comes to the controller without an OTG cable. Because if you want to use the spark right out of the box with either your smartphone or the controller over a Wi-Fi connection, you will have a really hard time with the connection. Like with only your smartphone, the spark will lose the connection at around 50 meter, and even with the controller over a Wi-Fi connection, you will only have around 200 meters to fly, which is really not that big of a distance, at least when it comes to filmmaking. For photos, this isn't that much of a problem, at least for me, but if I wanted to do some video work with it, I really had some problems I ran into. And this was really annoying for me, especially since the flight time of the spark is so limited and you can really watch the battery go down in real time. So if you want to buy the spark, get yourself the FlyMore combo, get yourself the controller plus an OTG cable to connect your controller manually to the smartphone. With the Wi-Fi connection, you will only have a lot of problems. So these are the three things I like the most about the spark, and I still like them, and the three things I really hate about the spark. And now to come to kind of a conclusion, would I still recommend buying the spark? For photography, in my opinion, it is really good, it is small, it is reliable. Even if the flight time isn't that long, it's still usable, especially since it's really affordable and, as I said, small and very quiet. But for videography, the spark is really unusable in my opinion. And I honestly think about selling my spark now because I cannot really work with it. And I feel like the Mavic, which costs around 400 euro more, is much more reliable and a much better tool for filmmaking. I even think about getting one of the Phantom drones in the next year, because I feel like even if they are much more expensive than the Mavic or the Spark, they are really reliable and really made for filmmaking, with the log profile, with the better flight time, the better flight behavior. They have a controller with a built-in screen, and these are just some things which would make my life as a filmmaker much more easier, and I feel like the higher price is really worth it in the end. So if you want to use Spark for just some amateur filmmaking and photography, you're really good to go with it, and I highly recommend getting it now, as it is on sale now and really cheap if you get it directly from DJI. But if you want to use the Spark for filmmaking, I would highly recommend to save some more money and buy either the Mavic or one of the Phantom drones, because they are just much more reliable, much better image quality, and they are just much more fun to fly. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you have any further questions regarding the Spark, drones in general, or filmmaking in general, don't hesitate to leave them down in the comments. I really appreciate all of your feedback. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I hope to see you guys in the next video.